Welcome back to my channel. I'm John, and this year I'll be doing a years long series on life experiences. And today I'm talking about problem solving. To be successful in life, be a problem solver. Pick a problem, any problem, and do something about it. Because those who are hurting, something is everything. And if you have an ability, then you have a responsibility. To be a problem solver, you need to have an attitude. An attitude that sees problems as opportunities as rather than obstacles. An attitude that is able to see problems in new ways rather than the ways that everyone else has seen them. And the underpinning of these attitude is conviction. The ability to prepare, and the answers will come. To be a problem solver, you need to be able to redefine the problem. So often we're given the problem, but it's incomplete, or it has an incorrect definition. So you need to redefine and take your own lead. Have a system. Every problem is different, but your methodology in solving that problem, unpacking it and working through it, will inevitably be the same. Also, take time to understand why things didn't work before, and don't fall into the experience trap. Because like the saying goes, you can't solve today's problems with yesterday's answers. To be a problem solver, you need to be able to walk in other people's shoes. See the problem the way the hurt see them. Different perspectives are key to being a good and effective problem solver. Not every problem has one view. And from some angles, it doesn't even look like a problem. Problem solving can be competitive, especially when the stakes are high. And the sharing of information can be reluctant. But a good problem solver can flush out the important information and still manage conflict. To be a problem solver, you need to be able to develop a good intuition, especially in the latter stages of problem solving. Listening to your gut feeling and instincts, testing and retesting the notions, are all important, because sometimes that's all you have to go on once you've become well acquainted with the problem at hand. Be willing to go beyond the solving the immediate problem. So often answering one problem leads to another problem, or the answer to the problem lies within how badly someone answered a problem before. Maybe you need to unpick the solution of another problem to solve your own problem. But a good problem solver will push further in their approach to problem solving, so often more unexpected opportunities arise. Good problem solvers don't just solve a problem short term. They want to solve the problem permanently. So they don't just do a quick job, then move on to the next problem. They address all aspects surrounding the issue and will ensure that the problem stays solved and doesn't come back to bite them later. To be a good problem solver, you need to be an effective communicator. Because once you've solved the problem, you need to ensure everybody knows not just the solution, but why it went wrong in the first place. And I'm not saying you have to talk them through every step on how you got the solution, but they certainly need to know what went wrong and why. They need to know specific information to ensure the problem doesn't happen again. It's all part of long-term solutions. At the end of the day, a good problem solver is not just one who asks questions, but does research to understand why something is a problem and to find the long-term solution, we need to understand where things went wrong, or where they started to go wrong to begin with, and not just to the point where we've picked that problem up. And don't just be a problem solver giving out solutions. Be willing to be part of the solution to other people's work. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to give a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, and you will get updates for the next video. And until the next video, I will see you soon.